What if I told you that black holes are not that black? Sounds silly, but it's true.
Back in 1974, Stephen Hawking made an amazing prediction, Hawking radiation. To understand it, anyway, we have to start from the beginning. The first thing you have to understand is the following.
Black holes are bodies with such strong gravitational fields that nothing can escape from them. If you're far away from a black hole, then you're not in danger, but watch out. If you get close to one of them, you'll be running the risk of your life. Once you get to the event horizon, you've got nothing to do. There's absolutely nothing that can escape a black hole once it has passed its horizon, not even light. And that's why they're black. They do not reflect or emit any light because every single photon that arrives at a black hole stays there forever. And here's the second thing you should know before getting started on Hawking radiation. In the universe, there's no such thing as an absolute vacuum. You can have the emptiest space, but even then, you won't have an absolute vacuum. Why? Welcome to virtual particles. Constantly, in every single place in the universe, there are pairs of particles popping in and out of existence, out of nothing. Hold on, isn't energy not supposed to be created? That's right, that's why we call these virtual particles. They just appear and annihilate each other, ending up by disappearing in a really small fraction of a second. And this is happening everywhere, even around good cats. Anyway, the total energy in the universe must be conserved, so every single pair of virtual particles that appears ends up popping out of existence. Sounds like fiction, but it's real. Now, particles themselves are not little balls, but understanding them as if they were may be very useful for what's coming up next. Finally, welcome to Hawking radiation. Stephen Hawking thought the following. What if a pair of these virtual particles appear just in the event horizon of a black hole? Technically, one of them could escape, unlike the other one. So, if only one particle of the pair falls into the black hole, the other one won't be annihilated. It will go away, turning into a real particle, adding mass to the universe.
Wait, are we creating matter? Not really. As I said before, the total energy in the universe must be conserved, so what is exactly happening here? Well, as one virtual particle of the pair becomes real, which technically adds mass to the universe, you have to subtract that same amount of mass from somewhere. That is the only way that the total energy in the universe will be conserved.
So, bad news for black holes. When one of these virtual particles fall in, letting the other escape, it acquires a weird characteristic, which we could understand as having negative energy. And when a particle with negative energy enters a black hole, the black hole loses energy because you're adding a negative number.
And this loss of energy is basically a loss of mass. So the black hole is losing mass. And this is the best part. If the black hole is emitting particles, it's radiating. This is what Hawking predicted.
Black holes emit radiation, which in essence means that they emit light.
We cannot see this light, but it is there. Black holes are not that black. And this phenomenon has a second consequence.
If black holes are losing mass, they will at some moment get to disappear. They are evaporating. And the smaller a black hole is, the stronger its surface gravity is. This implies a higher temperature, which translates as radiating more. So, basically, as a black hole evaporates, it begins to evaporate faster. At the end of its life, the black hole will be rapidly losing mass until it dies in a big, powerful explosion. Now, what's important about this theory is that it joins concepts of quantum mechanics and relativity, the two fundamental pillars of modern physics, and this takes us one step closer to finding a theory of everything. So, will you keep calling them black holes?